So, you know, in medicine, we have tolerated these unprofessional behaviors. And just to review, unprofessional behaviors is defined by behaviors that undermine relational trust and therefore undermine psychological safety. And I think there are many reasons that we've tolerated them. And I think it's important to look at them because otherwise we'll keep tolerating them. So I think the first is that sometimes people who are behaving this way are very valuable to the organization. They bring in a lot of money. They bring grants in. They have a big positive reputation, and I think leaders see the positive side of these people. I think the answer to that is there's a huge hidden cost of allowing these people to continue these behaviors. And so even from a financial point of view, it's sort of a lose-lose situation if you continue to tolerate them. So for example, we know that behaviors like this have a negative effect on patient safety, which nobody wants. They have a negative effect on morale, retention, productivity, lawsuits, lots of things that are costly if we don't address them. So money is one. Another, I think, hesitance to confront or hold people accountable for these behaviors is sometimes people who are behaving this way are also very powerful, and we're afraid that they'll retaliate. Even top leaders are afraid of retaliation. So I think you have to build in to the program very, very clear ways to protect people from retaliation, either from reporting or from, holding the person accountable. And there are absolutely ways to doing that, including pointing out to the person that every organization has strict anti-retaliation policies, and then holding them to that. I think another is, I don't think we really realized the ill effect these behaviors have on people individually and well-being, and also even patient safety. And I think there's just a lot more data now that we can help educate people that this behavior, where we thought it was okay, isn't, for many reasons. Including, I think there's been a myth of the pedagogic rationale that, this is how I was trained, and, this is how I'm gonna make him a good surgeon, or what have you, that we thought it was sort of the way to do it. We now know, of course, that actually humiliating people, demeaning them, decreases their learning. No question. In fact, there was a study that looked at skill acquisition, technical skill acquisition, and found that it was better achieved in the absence of strong arousals. And, there's nothing like increasing your arousal rate than being humiliated as you're trying to learn a technical skill. So I think that's a big one. And then, finally, I think that we really didn't appreciate the importance of, in addition to technical and cognitive skills, the need to be professional, the need to be a good team player, the need to understand systems. In other words, the other competencies. And these behaviors relate to these other non-technical competencies. And I think now we, of course, understand both educationally and in terms of outcomes of our work, that these are really important skills to have. So I think we're in a better position now to stop tolerating the behavior and to work on remediation and improvement than we were in the past when we didn't really have the data.